G'day. In this video, we're going to go over the steps required to communicate with a Modbus TCP device using GrooveView. I'm going to be using this GrooveEPIC Learning Center. Now, it's perfect for learning more about GrooveEPIC or doing a proof of concept project. I'm also going to be using this Saitek P130 power meter as my Modbus TCP device. It's measuring the voltage and frequency of the mains power here in the studio, and our goal is to display that data in GrooveView. To get started, you'll need the IP address of your Modbus device and the host name of your EPIC processor. You'll also need the Modbus device address registers, and this is usually found in the manual or a supplementary manual for the device. You'll also need both devices on the same network as your laptop. So go ahead, open a browser on your computer and go to https://, the host name of your EPIC processor. Log in, and from the home page, select GrooveView. Start by going to the build mode from the menu in the top right. First, we need to add a page to our project. We can start by giving it a name. Let's add a title bar. Giving it a name. And flicking over to the handheld view, we can see that this page is being built at the same time as the desktop and tablet view. Now let's go ahead and add the Modbus TCP device. Click on Devices and Tags, and then Add New Device. Select Modbus Device from the drop-down list, giving it a name. Here we can enter the IP address and the port number. These are set in your Modbus device. We can leave all the other settings as their default, except for base 1 addressing. In the case of this Saitek power meter, the address of the register is the correct byte order, so we can clear this check mark. You'll need to check your manual for your device, or simply try it each way and check your results. Once that's done, we can now configure the tags on the device. Let's start with voltage. Look at the device manual to find the register address and any scaling that may be needed to be done. Now that we have that information, we can start by giving it a name. It's a 16-bit unsigned integer. Its address is from a holding address 256. It's read-only. And if we just stop here and ran the project, we would just see the raw 16-bit number. It would not be very helpful, so we need to rescale it into engineering units, in this case, volts AC. From the manual, we know that our upper value in raw counts is 9,999, and a lower value of zero raw counts. The result is a floating point number that scales to 144 upper volts and zero lower volts. Let's now add the frequency. The process is the same. You get the register address, the scaling values, and the conversion formula from the device manual, and then you enter it into the tag. Give it a name. It's a 16-bit unsigned integer. Its address is 279. It's a read-only value. And the scaling is much the same as voltage. It can be a raw count of 9,999 maximum to zero counts minimum. The scaled result is a floating point number with a maximum of 65 Hz and a minimum of 45 Hz. Now our data points are set up and we can add them to any gadgets that we want. I'm going to make the frequency a dial gauge. Make the range pretty narrow and add a coloured range indicator around the 60 Hz point. For the voltage, I'm going to use a range indicator. Click, drag, drop it onto the workspace. Now set up the range, 115 to 120 volts. Set the units. And let's put a green range indicator on this one as well. Let's save our changes and see this screen in view mode now. And there we go. We can see the data presented clearly and in engineering units. For more information about GuruView, check out training.opta22.com. Till next time, cheers, mate.